was from Evanston, Illinois, and I decided I needed to get out of there. And I had this dream of going to London, mainly to marry Paul McCartney. That was a tragedy because I was not an attractive child. My front teeth were in another time zone. They were about an hour in front of my face.
Good afternoon, welcome.
I wanted to be an actress. My school play had about 6,000 people in it. Hello, Dolly, and they gave me the role of Earthworm. So I wasn't necessarily talented, but I decided I would become a classical actress based on nothing. So I flew over at 17. Well, when I first got here, it was a prairie land. There was no loop paper, just something made out of wax paper. I don't want to discuss what happened. The food was appalling. You lived in darkness. Darkness, and it was horrifying. I was one of the few Americans that could tolerate being here in those days. I auditioned for Rada. As Juliet, I wore a wimple. It was a horrible, I got rejected 7 times. Never wear a wimple when you go in a doorway, by the way, it'll rip your neck off. I got into Glasgow because nobody in London would take me, and I did tongue exercises there for about 3 years to get the English accent I have today. Anyway, after that, I got into the Royal Shakespeare Company. Again, that's just sheer drive. Well, maybe because they liked what I could do with my tongue. And we were working with Alan Rickman, and he said to me, "Why don't you write the way you speak?" So I wrote, and I threw all the papers at him, and he said it was like somebody threw up on him. But the deal was then, when he did Robin Hood, I had to write his lines. So I did. But I got no credit and no money. I somehow knew there was gold in them hills. So it was worth the whole thing. Oh, and by the way, can I say this? I got an OBE this year. So it really was worth getting on the plane. Anyway, it took off for me in London. It never would have worked in America. Every time I take a show there, it's like lettuce that comes from France. It tastes really good there, and it comes here, it's like toilet paper. Do we have to start over? My most amazing destination was Bhutan, because they hadn't been corrupted yet at all. There were no fancy hotels. The food tasted like a yak sneezed down your throat. But to see another way of living that wasn't about money was extraordinary. My relationship with travel has changed, so I started to pay for business, and then suddenly my life changed completely. The fact that I could lie on my back changed my world. When I'm in the air, that's usually when I write my best, because I got nothing else to do and nobody can get in touch. So when I used to write, well, the ab-fab scripts, clang, that's where I'd write it, in the plane. And I was hilarious, I thought, until I landed. People said, it's not as good as you thought it was. Of course, I drink a lot on the flight too, so that might have helped. I don't see anything as thrilling in my life. It's getting on a plane and then having a surprise when I get off. There's nothing in school, or nobody can teach you, or there's no book that can expand your brain, your mind, as much as travel. Nothing will take you by surprise like that. But I really appreciate when I land, if you want me to be honest.